بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. الله جل جلاله ومن والاه سنت أنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام to humanity. إنسان ميدان is dunya. Anbiya alayhi salatu salam's medan was the hearts of insan. Primarily, the heart is the markaz of this world. Ala inna fil jasadi mudgha, and this piece of flesh is reformed. Saluha al jasadu kulluhu, the entire body, from the body it transmits to the environment, from the environment to the entire earth. Everything becomes reformed when this heart is reformed. For the reformation of the hearts, Allah sent Anbiya alayhi salatu was salam. There is no Anbiya now. Inna al-ulama warthatul Anbiya. The inheritors of Anbiya are amongst our midst. So we should try to take benefit from these ulama that in our gatherings, in our midst, if a person is not bad to a sheikh, then let's just try to take bad to a sheikh. Likewise, from the ilm of the ulama, let us see how we can take benefit. A person has a problem with a vehicle, who's the specialist? Based on the speciality of the car, does it go to that specialist? He's going to repair it. This is the workshop. It can't happen that it'll get repaired at home. No, it needs those specific equipment. It needs that technology for it to be repaired. For us, our repair place is in the masjid, and the master mechanics are the ulama, are the sulaha, who are the master mechanics who know how to run these mechanisms as well. Likewise, there's a zarurat, a need. A person wants kebab. Who do they go to? The kebab wala. Where's the shop where they sell in the kebabs? Any ingredient that you want, you go to the place which stores it. If you want Allah, you have to go to the Allah Wala, those people who can direct you to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Akim Sahib Akhtar Rahmatullahi used to always give the example. He used to say that in the tea there's the sugar, but if you drink it, you're not going to enjoy the sugar. To get the sweetness of the sugar, you need the spoon that will stir it. He said the Allah Wala is the friends of Allah. We've got deen, we know what deen is, but to get the sweetness of deen, to get the ecstasy of deen. So when I wake up, Allah, Allah, when I sleep, Allah, Allah, my every movement, Allah, Allah. You have to go to the Allah walas who will make that movement in the ruh, that ruhaniyat and that spirituality that will bring that kayfiyat and that condition which is matlub and demanded. That our statement be the same statement of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Whether it's my ibadat, whether it's my eating, whether it's my sleeping, whether it's my loving, whether it's my dying, lillahi rabbil alameen. There's only one head of this. Man kana lillah, kana allahu lahu. You become Allah's, Allah will become yours. The shirt is, مَنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ شِبْرًا. I need to take the step. I need to move forward. I need to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am genuine. In the world where everything is a fake, even a person who buys a brand, buys a fake brand, he takes pride on a fake. Imagine if he had the genuine. We take in pride on the fake idols. All the dunyawi idols, all the dunyawi brands, I'm taking pride on that. If I take pride on Rabbul Alameen, what will happen? A youngster was walking. He seen a young girl. He started following her. So she noticed him following her. So she went to one corner and she waited for him. As he came around the corner, she confronted him. Hey, what do you want? So he looked at her in the eyes directly and he said, love at first sight. So she smiled. She said, I'm flattered. But can I tell you a secret? My sister is prettier than me. She just crossed the road. He turned to look. She gave him one smack. Kadhab, you liar. You said love at first sight. What happened to the love? So it shouldn't be Allah protect one and all. We say, I love Allah. But we look in our gazes at dunya. Allah's smack should also not come. وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ. Should not happen. So we need to affiliate ourselves with the ulama. MashaAllah, Hazrat Maulana Sahil Sahib Damat Barakatuh, MashaAllah, for so many years has been amongst our mutts in our gathering. They say we worship the dead people nowadays. We don't worship the living. Only when somebody is gone, we say, hey, he was such a good person and he used to do this. We only wait for people to die, then we value them. When we are alive, we don't value people as well. So wherever it's in our midst, let us value these people. These are the rijal of Allah, the men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who their night and day are dedicated. I'll give you one example. Today is the day of majlis and we'll conclude on this here. Is a person had a problem, this person had a problem, where he used to think that there were monsters under his bed. So he went to a psychologist and he was going for treatment, but he couldn't sleep. He was restless. 1 month, 2 months, 5 months, 6 months, 2 years passed. Still very restless. So it costed him a lot of money. He's still not sleeping at night. He decided, told the last session, you know what, this is the end of it now. It's cost me money in my life. 2 years gone, no benefit whatsoever. So the psychologist understood, let him go. Just a little bit of time after that, immediately, they were at a restaurant and the psychologist seen this man here. He was very happy and elated and said, Hazrat, are you very happy? Are you okay? Your things are sorted? He said, yeah. He said, and the nightmares that you've been having, is that problem you're still suffering? He said, no, it's sorted out. He said, how? He said, you see, I've been coming to you, the psychologist. I decided to go to a behaviorist. A behaviorist. I went for one session. I told him my problem. He said, cut the legs of your bed. Just cut the legs of your bed. He said, my problem is solved now. I don't think so. There's all monsters under my bed. There's no bed left. So what took 2 years and couldn't get solved in one session got solved. When we spend time with the ulama, we want to accelerate al-jannatu aqrabu ila ahadikum min shiraqina alihi. Jannat is closer to you than your shoelace. Wa an-naru mithla dhalika. Jahannam is also close. You decide which route you want to take. Spend time with ahlullah, they'll grab you and take you to Jannah. And spend time with the wrong company, we don't know where we can go. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq wa miki nam.
Dekho, mere azizo, Hazrat Mufti Ahmed sahab, damat barakatuh, madam Allahu fuyuzahu. Allah ta'ala Hazrat Mufti sahab ko jazaye khair de. May Allah azza wa jal reward him. Bahut badi aur bhari qurbani dekar yahan hamare shahar mein, mulk mein tashreef laaye hain. اللہ عز و جل ہم سب کی طرف سے ان کو جزائے خیر نصیب فرمائے. ہم نے ہماری آنکھوں سے ان کا شغل دیکھا ہے. واللہ انتہا مشغول آدمی ہے. A very very busy person. اور one after the other ان کے یہاں علماء کی آمد و رفت, جماعتوں کا آنا جانا, بزرگوں کا آنا جانا, مدرسے میں پڑھانے جانا. And Mufti Sahib's teaching is such that he teaches in different cities, in different Darul Ulooms. So an extremely busy person. Allah has blessed him with ilm and amal. And he has made a sacrifice and alhamdulillah, he has come to our town and our masjid especially. There are requests for Mufti Sahib to attend other masajid and other programs. Abito Mufti Sahib hadn't even arrived and I was making mashwara about going to Batli because Batli walon ka taqaza tha. The people from Batli wanted Mufti Sahib to go there. But because we wanted to benefit from Mufti Sahib directly, and Mufti Sahib's schedule and time was such that traveling we wanted to restrict, for this reason, this program was set in this way. Hazrat Mufti Sahib, the muzakara that he's been doing with the Masturat, jo teen dino se jo sabak ho raha hai wahan, intiha mufid, extremely beneficial, going into the depths of our daily needs and requirements. To ye Allah ka fazal hai, ye Allah ki ni'mat hai, that Allah Ta'ala gives us these opportunities. So we must take full advantage. Hazrat Mufti Sahib is also the majaz of Hazrat Maulana Abdul Hamid Sahib. Hazrat Mufti Sahib ko Hazrat Maulana Abdul Hamid Sahib damat barakatuh madam Allah fuyuzahum se ijazat hasil hai suluk mein. To maine to Hazrat Mufti Sahib se darkhast ki thi ki aap zikr karaye. I requested Mufti Sahib that today is Thursday evening, and alhamdulillah our normal people who attend the majlis on a daily basis, they also partake in the zikr on a Thursday evening. And many, many people in their homes, they take part in the zikr majlis. Lekin Arabi ka ek usool hai. Al-amru fawq al-adab. The instruction takes precedence over respect. Ke jab koi hukam kar de, to ehtiram se zyada ahmiyat hukam ko hai. تو حضرت مفتی صاحب کا حکم یہ ہے کہ چونکہ ہم کراتے ہیں عام طور پر یہاں ذکر تو ہم ہی کرائیں. تو حضرت مفتی صاحب کے حکم کی ماتحتی میں ہم عادت کے مطابق ذکر کرائیں گے. We will do the ذکر how we normally do it. لیکن حضرت مفتی صاحب کی موجودگی میں مجھے خود شرم آ رہی ہے. But because it's an instruction, then we will do the ذکر انشاءاللہ العزیز. So firstly, ذکر کے آداب جو ہیں جو آپ نے بار بار ہم سے سنے ہیں لیکن مذاکرے کے طور پر مختصراً عرض کر دیتے ہیں. That when we sit for ذکر face towards the قبلہ and you think that you are under the عرش of Allah سبحانہ وتعالی, یہ تصور پیدا کریں کہ ہم اللہ کے عرش کے تلے ہیں, اور ہمارے ذکر کے دوران اللہ کے عرش سے ایک نور نازل ہو رہا ہے. There is a beaming light descending from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that light is entering our hearts. And as this noor, jab ye noor hamare quloob mein aur dilon mein dakhil ho raha hai, to dilon ki zulmat, dilon ka andhera khatam ho raha hai. The darkness of the hearts, the same darkness that Hazrat Mufti Sahib mentioned yesterday, this darkness leaves our heart and is leaving our heart. So we sit towards the qibla, and we think that we are under the arsh of Allah Azza wa Jal. There is this noor descending in what we are saying, La ilaha illallah. And when we say La ilaha, that there is no deity besides Allah, we're removing everything ghayrullah from our hearts. Ke jab hum La ilaha illallah padhte hain, zikr karte hain iska, to jab hum La ilaha kahe, ke Allah ke alawa koi maabood nahi, Allah ke alawa kuch nahi, تو دلوں میں سے غیر اللہ کا نکالنا ہے. اللہ یہ کہتے ہوئے اللہ کو ہمارے دلوں میں داخل کرنا ہے. We entering Allah عز و جل into our hearts. کہاں ہمارے دل اور کہاں اللہ رب العزت کی ذات اقدس. تو اس تصور سے, اس نیت سے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ کے نام کی برکت, کلمے کی برکت سے اللہ تعالیٰ ہمارے قلوب کی قدورت کو ختم فرمائے. With this noble intention that Allah Azza wa Jal enters our hearts, Allah takes away the filth and the najasat from our hearts. Dilon mein kaun si najasat hai? Kya hum cholesterol ki baat kar rahe hain? Are we talking about cholesterol? What is in our hearts? Hasad hai, kina hai, bughz hai, adawat hai, dunya ki muhabbat hai, maal ki muhabbat hai. Allah ke alawa jitni cheeze hain, sab ki muhabbat ko dil se nikalni hai. We want to take out the love of anything and everything from our hearts. And we want to instill the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. Aur isi tariqe se, when we are saying the name of Allah, Allah ke naam ke zikr mein, to Hazrat, hamare Hazrat Hazrat Maulana Abdul Hamid sahab damat barakatuh madam Allah fuyuzahum farmate hain hamesha, ki agar koi aadmi aashiq hai, to iski maashuqa ko wo yaad karta hai, jisse isko muhabbat ho gayi hai. تو وہ اس کا نام لینے میں بھی لذت پاتا ہے, تو اس کا نام لیتا ہے لذت سے. اور حضرت ہمیشہ پتہ نہیں کیا ہے, لیکن حضرت فاطمہ کا نام لیتے ہیں تو فرماتے ہیں فاطمہ فاطمہ, کیونکہ اس کو فاطمہ سے محبت ہو گئی ہے تو اس نام کو وہ ایک لذت سے لیتا ہے. تو یہ تو رب ذوالجلال کا نام ہے. اللہ is a very unique word. علامہ بیضاوی رحمہ اللہ has explained why Allah is Allah. What is in the word Allah? And so beautifully he has explained it. So our love should be for Allah. So when we take his name, we should take his name with love. Whilst uttering his beautiful name, we should demonstrate the love for his name. تو اس طریقے سے قبلہ رخ ہو کر کے دھیان سے facing the قبلہ with devotion and dedication, we make the dhikr. And the intention is that Allah Azza wa Jal, he softens our hearts, he cleanses our heart. And our hearts draw towards Allah Azza wa Jal. Like Hazrat Mufti Sahab just mentioned, مَنْ كَانَ لِلَّهِ كَانَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. جو اللہ کا ہو گیا, اللہ اس کا ہو گیا. Whoever becomes Allah's, then Allah has become his. اگر تو میرا تو ہر شے میری. If Allah is ours, then everything is ours. اگر تو نہیں میرا تو کچھ نہیں میرا. If Allah is not ours and we are not becoming for Allah, then we have nothing. تو یہ ہے غرض اور یہ ہے غایت ذکر کی. اللہ تعالی ہم سب کو عمل کی توفیق نصیب فرمائے.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. اب تو رہے بستاد میں آخر ورد زباں اے میرے الہ. اب تو رہے بستاد میں آخر ورد زباں اے میرے الہ. لا الہ الا اللہ محمد رسول اللہ صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم لا إله إلا الله 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 لا إله 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 إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم الله الله كتنا پیارا نام ہے الله الله کتنا پیارا نام ہے عاشقوں کا مینا اور جام ہے عاشقوں کا مینا اور جام ہے اللہ جل جلاله وعم نواله الله 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 Allah, 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 جل جلاله وعم نواله. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا نبينا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم.
اب مہمان بھی ہے مسافر بھی ہے.
الحمد للہ رب العالمین والصلاة والسلام على اشرف الانبیاء والمرسلین وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يا أول الأولين ويا آخر الآخرين ويا ذا القوة المتين ويا راحم المساكين ويا أرحم الراحمين يا هنان يا منان يا رحمن يا ديان يا رب العالمين. اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله ولك الملك كله لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد كلما ذكره الذاكرون وصل على سيدنا محمد كلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الليل إذا يخشى وصل على سيدنا محمد في النهار إذا تجلى. يا ربي يا ربي يا ربنا يا الله يا أحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. يا الله يا رب العالمين يا الله you have said أنتم الفقراء إلى الله. Ya Allah, like a faqir, like a beggar, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, the beggars of the dunya know how to ask, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we don't know how to ask, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, but you have said, وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. If somebody begs from you, don't ever leave empty-handed. Ya Allah, we have come with gunas, bags of gunas, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we sin in the darkness of the night. Ya Allah, we sin in the brightness of the day. Ya Allah, our lives are filled with ma'asiyat and sin, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, but innama amruhu idha arada shay'an ay yaqula lahu kun. Ya Allah, what your permission, Ya Allah. Just your one ijazat, Ya Allah. Like a newborn child, Ya Allah. Your Nabi has said in this majlis of dhikr, when people leave, يا الله like a newborn child they leave قوموا مغفورا لكم all their sins are forgiven يا الله on the umid in the wasta in the hope of the words of your Nabi يا الله يا الله with our hands in front of you like beggars يا الله يا الله on the wasila of the elderly of the majlis يا الله on the wasila of the young of this majlis يا الله on the wasila of any good deed that anybody done in this majlis, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are begging you, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are asking you, Ya Allah, to make our maghfirat, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are asking you, Ya Allah, to make the maghfirat of our families, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, the hal of the ummah is such, Ya Allah, that it deserves tornadoes, Ya Allah, and it deserves whirlwinds, Ya Allah, and it deserves tremors, Ya Allah, and it deserves volcanic eruptions, Ya Allah. And we deserve bolts of lightning from the sky, Ya Allah. And we need earthquakes from the earth, Ya Allah. But Ya Allah, you have said, لَوْ بَلَغَدْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَا If you commit guna, and you commit guna, and you commit so much guna, it reaches the heavens. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي You lift your hands and you ask me for forgiveness. Ya Allah, you have said, غَفَرْتُ لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي I'll forgive all your gunas, I'll forgive all your sins, and I won't worry about it, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, in your words, we are asking you, Ya Allah, to make the maghfirat of the ummah, Ya Allah. Whoever's in difficulty, Ya Allah, remove all the hardships, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, whoever's in debt, Ya Allah, you remove all the debts, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, whoever in wherever parts of the world, the ummah is pareshan, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, you open up roads for the ummah, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, and if the emergence of Hazrat Mahdi comes, Ya Allah, then you make us part of his jama'at, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, and the emergence of Dajjal comes, Ya Allah, make sure that we are not part of his jama'at, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you on the wasila of your beloved Nabi to accept our dua and make us from your maqbool bandas. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين